everybody. Welcome back to my channel. I am Chris Hutchinson. I am sorry I haven't posted on time or in the last week or two. I have been busy working. It's not due to because I didn't want to film. It's just that I didn't have time to film. So I do apologize. Today we're going to be talking about the live action movie Cruella. I am really excited to give you my thoughts and opinion on this film. Not only was this a great film in general, but I have watched it at least 4 to 5 times already. I'm going to be explaining to you what happened throughout the movie, giving you my thoughts and opinion, and then giving you my opinions on upcoming sequels for this film. And yes, Disney has already released saying they're going to be making a sequel to this film. So spoiler alert, if you haven't watched this movie, make sure you go check it out. Otherwise, keep on watching. Make sure you're clicking that thumbs up button and also subscribing to my YouTube channel for more future content.
Cruella de Vil, Cruella de Vil, she's born to be bad, so run for the hills.
We're diving into one of my favorite Disney villains, Cruella de Vil. Now, we all know her from the 1960s animation film where she tries to kill 101 Dalmatians for fur coat. And Disney made a live-action film to 101 Dalmatians with Glenn Close starring as Cruella de Vil, and that got 2 live-action movies. Now, this is a backstory of how Cruella became Cruella, playing or starring Emma Stone. Now, I really thought that the casting was great in this film. First off, I thought Emma Stone played a great job as a Cruella and Estella playing 2 characters. I thought that the male actors who played Horace and Jasper did a great job in this film. I thought the actor who played Jasper was fantastic. I thought some of the scenes that you saw him in were spot on similarities from the animation film from the 1960s. He really had the slender profile. He was very tall in the film, and I really love that they captured some of those old traits from the original animation film. And I also loved that Horace was a comedian throughout this film. He had a little one-liner parts here and there. And in an interview that I watched him with, a lot of his scenes got cut. But, you know, he was just happy to be part of this film. And I'm glad he was, because he was one of my new favorite characters also. And not only did we get those characters, but we got a new out and proud gay member as well. Fashion designer to help Estella / Cruella in the film, which is props to Disney. So the movie starts off Estella being born. She found out she had kind of this weird personality trait with Cruella, kind of like 2 personality-ish almost, kind of almost Jacqueline High almost. And her mother tried to tell her to keep Cruella inside, don't let her out. And basically, we see her grow up through grade school, getting bullied, you know, all getting in trouble. And then eventually, her and her mother decides to move to London. And before they get to move to London, they make a pit stop to the Baroness house. We don't know why they were there, but this is where the movie gets dark really fast. Basically, it's a big fashion show, and next you know, Estella's getting chased by the Dalmatians, and then the Dalmatians basically go outside, or basically Estella runs outside with the Dalmatians, and that's where her mother was, meeting with the Baroness, and basically the Dalmatians push her mother over a cliff, which got really dark really fast, and Estella dropped her family heirloom necklace in the process of all this on the Baroness property. And then she tried to escape and gets to London where they were originally heading. I really felt that Disney did a great job of keeping this film kind of dark, I would say 90% of the time, with the humor being thrown in there 10% of the time. So Estella gets to London. She's all sad because she just lost her mother and also thinks she was part of the reason for her mother's deaths. Death. Part of her mother's death. Then she sleeps on this fountain and Horace and Jasper shows up as kids and basically they get chased down by the cops and then basically they invite Estella to be part of the gang. Years pass and they basically become common thieves, stealing, pickpocketing, and basically trying to move up to bigger heights. I really got a lot of GTA meets Ocean's 8 meets Cruella de Vil Disney. So there's a lot of different aspects in this film. So on that note, so they become these big thieves and keeps trying to get bigger and bigger ticket items. And then eventually on Stella's birthday, Jasper surprises her and got her a job interview at this big time fashion store in London. But apparently, we see her in her work field. She got the lowest job. She's basically the janitor slash cleaner of the place. And she gets kind of treated really badly there. I wouldn't say this is a glamour film, but we'll get to the fashion part here soon. Eventually, Estella has a rough day at work, like we all do. And she has to work overtime. And then she decides to have a drink and change up a window display she's been trying to give her thoughts and opinion on. But doing that, she catches the eye of the Baroness, showing the roles that the Baroness will play in her life. So she ends up going to work for the Baroness, and she loves fashion. She always likes fashion. She designs these great costumes for her little heist. That's where I said like this kind of like this GTA Grand Theft Auto stuff. And so she basically starts designing fashion for the Baroness. And one day she noticed the Baroness was wearing the necklace she lost as a kid. And she wants the necklace back. She wants the necklace back. And this is where I say it kind of gets into this Ocean 8 vibe with trying to steal a necklace. And they did it with three people. So Estella basically says Cruella will be coming to this ball to crash the ball while Horace and Jasper tries to steal the necklace. And at the ball, she definitely crashes it in this beautiful red gown, does a huge reveal. And I might say it was probably one of the best reveals I have seen in a long time. And then she realized that in the midst of crashing the film and trying to get the Baroness attention, or she had some one-on-one time with the Baroness, things got out of hand and the Baroness blows this whistle that summons the Dalmatians, or basically is a dog whistle, which unlocks a memory in Estella's head that she was blowing the whistle to kill her mother. So we have find out that the Baroness killed Estella's mother, and Cruella escapes from the party, devastated that she figures out who killed her mother. So after the party, Cruella noticed that one of the Dalmatians had ate the necklace they were trying to steal. So the next day, Cruella wants to go. Is still Cruella trying to upstage the Baroness. And she says, we need to get these Dalmatians. So they actually steal Dalmatians in this film. And I'm really happy they did some dog stealing in this film. And with Horace and Jasper, they did it in a comedic way as well. And so that's the best part of it. There was dog napping in this film. And so he wants revenge on the Baroness. And she does this cool way of bringing Cruella into this movie, where basically Cruella is this high fashionista, where she has all these cool different designs and outfits, and she crashes each event of the Baroness. And also, being undercover as Estella working for the Baroness, she's kind of playing this cool two-part field. And I'm just really surprised the Baroness hasn't really catch on that Estella is really Cruella. So you've got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? It's always tease, tease, tease. You're happy when I'm on my knees. One day is fine and next is black. So you want me off your back? One of my favorite parts of the film was Estella was making this beautiful dress for the Baroness. And there was all this beading she had to do overnight. And basically, all the dresses get put into a safe. And then during the fashion show, they couldn't get the safe open. And they open the safe and all these moths come flying off. And we find out that each bead that Estella sewed on her dress were actually a moth seed, which was so clever because the moths ate all her clothes. And then suddenly she's throwing another fashion show competing with the Baroness. So during this fashion show, Estella's wearing this beautiful black and white coat that looked like to be Dalmatian fur.
She killed my dogs. And made a coat.
Implying that that was real Dalmatians. And that's how Cruella got that label, saying that, you know, everyone loves a villain and she wanted to do it. And so the Baroness thought that that Cruella killed her Dalmatians, but she didn't. Those Dalmatians were safe. But basically the Baroness catches up with Cruella and does this whole reverse thing on her and basically tries to kill Cruella and burn her house down. And I thought this was very intense for Disney, and I really wish Disney would have went farther and gave it an R rating with, because they could have really gone dark in this film with these two characters, how vicious these two characters are.
Goodbye, Cruella. Off the press. I'd love them to know that you went out in a blaze of glory. Smile, for your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun.
And basically Cruella gets saved by the Baroness's butler, who kind of represents Alonzo in the live action film. We don't see Alonzo in the animation film, only in the live action film when Glenn Close was playing Cruella. And basically, this butler found the necklace that Cruella wanted and basically said that it's a key and there's more to the story, and basically gives Cruella this box that has her birth certificate in it, basically saying that she is the Baroness's daughter. Like, whoa. So basically, when Cruella was born, the Baroness wanted the child to be killed. She didn't want the child at all. She didn't want to put the child up for adoption. She's like, get rid of it. And that was pretty dark, but to find out that the Baroness is Cruella's mother, and we can see where Cruella gets her craziness from, it all makes sense. And then basically Cruella runs off because she has an emotional breakdown and realizing who she really is. And she goes back to the fountain where she goes talks to her mom to tell her what's going on. It's just like this real moment that this is like one of my favorite parts in the film, where Cruella is just a hot mess and she just breaks down and just says this. Here, I'm gonna play this clip for you.
So this is a confusing day. My nemesis is my real mother. And she killed my other mother. I guess you were always scared, weren't you, that I'd be a psycho like my real mother. That explains all the tone it down, try and fit in stuff. Love me into shape, I suppose, was the plan. I tried. I tried because I loved you. Thing is, I'm not sweet Estella. Try as I might, I never was. I'm cruel. Brilliant. Born bad. And a little bit mad. I'm not like her. I'm better. Anyway. Mustache. Much to avenge, revenge, and destroy.
At that moment, we knew that's Cruella. That's who she is right there. So this last heist in the film is really interesting because you have Estella and Cruella who wants revenge on the Baroness. How do you do it? Well, Estella thought of this huge scheme to get revenge on the Baroness, basically what she did was she got alone with the Baroness in the same location where her mother was pushed off, and she knew that the Baroness was going to do something evil. You can always count on a bad person doing a bad thing, basically. So she was prepared for that, but the Baroness wasn't. With that, she brought out all the guests from her party to witness what the Baroness was going to do. And basically the Baroness pushes Estella off of a cliff and everyone's shocked about it. It's like, oh my gosh, how can you do that? But Estella was smart enough to basically do this cool design thing with her skirt where it turns into a parachute, basically. And I'm not sure how technologically or advanced a skirt could be to do that, but it was really interesting to see. So basically, Cruella is saying that Estella's dead after basically pushing off, or basically when the Baroness pushes Estella off the cliff. And then Cruella shows up and the Baroness goes to jail and basically inherits everything that Estella inherits from the Baroness, making Cruella the wealthy woman that we know. And then in the end of the film, Cruella has a few more ideas what we can do. And then after the first end scene, we see another clip or a short clip where Anita and Roger get two Dalmatians, Pongo and Purdy, which were given by Cruella. Now, overall with this film, I really thought this film was great. I loved the acting. The music was really good with it. I thought the directing was an A-minus job on this film. And then also, I thought the writing was so good in this film. It wasn't cheesy. It wasn't at all over the top, but it wasn't all like, it wasn't bad writing like some of the Star Wars movies was, or even predictable. I remember watching it the first time with my mom, and she even said there was some Joker vibes in this film, which was I get it where she gets it, kind of Harley Quinn-ish. So my predictions for a sequel. Disney has already said that a sequel is already in the works. Not filming yet, but it's already discussed for a future film. Now, Disney can go left this movie wide open where they could go. The first one I would like to see is the Baroness will get out of jail and she would have to go up with Cruella. Now, we don't know how long the Baroness is going to be in jail for. Is it going to be for a couple of years or is it going to be a lot of years? If it's a couple of years, it'll probably still be still Emma Stone's version of Cruella. Or we noticed that Glenn Close was a producer on this movie. So if they brought Glenn Close back as Cruella or even as an older Cruella, that would be interesting to see Glenn Close go up with the Baroness before and kind of do like a before 101 Dalmatians. And that would be a cool like tie-in to 101 Dalmatians. Also, we have we also have Roger and Anita with Pongo and Purdy. Will they do a remake of the live action of the 101 Dalmatians with Emma Stone being Cruella de Vil? If that's the case, then there's this fan art that someone made, and I'm gonna post it right here. And I really would want to see this image of Cruella in the next film with Emma Stone. I want to see the fur coats. I want to see over-the-topness. I want to see the originalistic traits for Cruella in the next film, where it's big fur over-the-top. And then maybe we could see a glimpse of the Glenn's Close version. Unless if Disney wants to go full out and remake Cruella and give her a brand new image. And that might be also interesting as well. Also, in this film, there was some type of romantic relationship with Horace and Cruella, and maybe they might expand that. What are your thoughts and opinions on that? All I know is Disney has a lot of options for a sequel for this film. And unlike like Maleficent, where they still follow the rule book or the storyline of the original, anything's possible for this sequel and doesn't have to be a prequel or a or anything, or it can even continue on after this film where they left off. So it's very interesting to see how Disney ended this film. And it'll be even more interesting to see if they're going to make more Disney villain backstories as well with a live action take. What were your thoughts and opinions on this film? I would love to hear them down below in the comment sections. Also, click up that thumbs up button. Make sure you're liking each video of mine. Make sure you're subscribing to my channel. It's free for just be updated for the latest content. I'll try to be back every Friday at 9 a.m. Pacific Northwest time. I am Chris Hutchinson. Mwah! Till next time.
Cruella de Vil, she's born to be bad, so run for the hills. Cruella de Vil, Cruella de Vil, the fear on your face, it gives me a thrill. Who wants to be nice? Who wants to be tame? And all of your good guys, they all seem the same. Original criminal, dressed to kill, just call me Cruella de Vil. Call me crazy, call me insane, but you're stuck in the past, and I'm ahead of the game. A life lived in penance, it just seems a waste, and the devil has much better to taste. And I try to be sweet, right.